Now, let's have a look at adding memory to our LangChain application. And I think the best way to explain the benefit of memory is to have a look at something like ChatGPT. And we can use conversation memory to store each of these conversations separately, and that will allow our application to retrieve past conversations so that the user can continue with those conversations hours, days, or even months later. This is actually really easy to implement in LangChain, so let's get started. Let's remember to activate our virtual environment, and let's create a new file in our project called memory.py. Let's start by setting up the basics again, like importing our environment variables. Let's also import chat OpenAI, and let's also import our chat prompt template. Let's go ahead and instantiate our model by setting it equal to chat OpenAI. Let's set the model equal to GPT 3.5 Turbo, and for the temperature, I'll just set something like 0.7. And let's also set up a basic prompt by setting prompt equal to chat prompt template dot from messages. Let's first set our system message, which is equal to something like you are a friendly AI assistant, and let's also set our human message, which is simply a placeholder called input. Let's also create our chain by setting chain equal to prompt, and let's pipe in model. Lastly, let's test this by setting response equal to chain.invoke, and I'm actually going to create a separate variable for our message. I'll simply call it message, and let's set this equal to a dictionary with a key of input and a value of hello. This value needs to match whatever you entered in the prompt template. Now we can simply pass this into invoke, and let's actually print out response. Now let's test this in the terminal by running Python memory.py. And indeed, we do get our response back, so this is working. Now, you might be wondering how memory is different to what we covered in the previous two videos. If I open up the conversation retrieval file, and as a reminder, you can find this code in the description of this video, we added conversation history to this application by injecting a list into this messages placeholder. So during the conversation, we simply appended messages to this array, and if I go down to this code, we initiated a list called chat history, and then after calling the invoke method, we simply appended the human message as well as the AI message to that array. So when we executed this, it created the perception that there is some sort of conversation memory being implemented. But of course, we had to manually code all of this and then inject this chat history manually into the conversation during this invoke method. And the biggest issue with this solution is after we terminated the session, the entire chat history was cleared. And this is not what we want for our production-grade applications. We want this history to persist in a database of some sort so that when we open up our application again, we can simply continue with that conversation. So let me show you how easy it is to add conversation history to our application without us having to append to any lists or do any manual footwork. Let's start by importing something from LangChain. So from LangChain.memory, let's import the conversation buffer memory. So below our prompt, let's create a new variable called memory, and let's set this equal to conversation buffer memory. And this takes in a property called memory key, which we can give any value. I'll just call it chat history. And this will be used to inject this conversation history into the prompt template. So in the prompt template, let's actually add that messages placeholder, just like we did in the previous videos. So let's add messages placeholder, and we do need to import this as well. So let's do that now. So from prompts, let's also import messages placeholder, and messages placeholder takes in a property called variable name, which will set equal to chat history. Now, one thing to note about these buffer memory classes is that these will actually return the conversation history as a string by default, but you might recall from the previous videos that we actually had to pass in a list and not a string. So in order to get this class to return a list of values instead of a string, we can simply pass in one more property called return messages, which we'll set equal to true. Now we just need to attach this memory object to our chain somehow, and you might be prompted to simply add it to this chain, like so, but unfortunately, this does not work, as this memory object is not a runnable. So what we can do instead is just remove this from this chain. We need to create this chain in a slightly different way, and we will use a class that we will import from LangChain to do this. So at the top of the code, let's enter from langchain.chains import LLMChain. Then let's create our chain by setting it equal to LLMChain, and this takes in a few values as input, first being the LLM, which we called model. Then we can also pass in our prompt, which we called prompt, and we can also specify a memory property, which we called memory. And in order to debug this, let's also add verbose, and let's set this equal to true. And believe it or not, this is all we have to do to attach memory to our application. We will have a look at storing this in a database within a minute, but let's test this out, and you will already see how much simpler this solution is as opposed to manually building up the chat history in these previous two videos. Let's rename this to message 1, and let's change this to response 1. Let's pass in message 1 into its invoke method, and let's print response 1. I'm also going to copy this so that we can pass in a second message. So let's call this message 2. Let's call this response 2. This takes in message 2 as input, and we'll print response 2. Let's change these messages from hello to something like my name is Leon, and for message 2, what is my name? Let's go ahead and test this. And because we set verbose to true, we can actually see the contents of the formatted prompt template. So we can see the chat history that was injected, which contains the phrase my name is Leon. And finally, within this text property, we can see the answer saying your name is Leon. Hopefully you will agree that this is a way easier way of implementing memory. And of course, feel free to implement this loop solution so that you can converse with this in the terminal. But I'll just stick to this solution for now so that we can see exactly what this application is doing. Now, let's have a look at storing these messages in a persistent database. So how do we choose a database? If you go to the LangChain documentation under integration, and if you scroll down to this memory section, you can see that LangChain has support for several memory providers. And in this video, we'll actually implement Upstash Redis. This integration is just incredibly easy, and they offer a very generous free tier, and their services are not expensive either. So to get started, go over to upstash.com. You will find the link in the description of this video. Then click on log in. After logging in, ensure that you have this Redis option selected. Then click on create database. Give your database a name, then select a region and click on create. Then scroll down to this REST API section. Here you will find two buttons, one to copy the REST URL and another to copy the REST token. Let's first copy the URL, and I would recommend adding these to the environment variables, but for demonstration's sake, I'll simply paste these in the code itself. First, let's add the Upstash URL, then let's grab the token as well and add it to our code. I'm actually going to move this to the top of the logic, but again, I highly recommend adding these to the environment variables instead. Now, in order to use Upstash in our project, we do need to install one dependency. So in the terminal, enter pip install Upstash Redis. So back in our code, let's import something from LangChain, from langchain.langchainCommunity.chatMessageHistories.upstashRedis import Upstash Redis chat message history. And if you were wondering how on earth I knew where to import this from, you can simply have a look at the documentation for each of these providers. Now let's instantiate this by creating a new variable called history, which is equal to Upstash Redis chat message history. And this takes in a few properties. First is the URL, which we called Upstash URL. Then we also need to supply the token, which we called Upstash token. Then we also have to specify a session ID. And this is a unique identifier for this conversation. And this is what we'll use to retrieve the conversation from the database so that we can continue with that conversation. Of course, in an actual application, you might want to generate a unique ID and then store that unique ID against a user profile. But for this demo, I'll simply hard code it to something like chat1. And then optionally, we can also specify a value called TTL or time to live. And this is a value in seconds. And if you specify a value of 0, it simply means this conversation will never expire. Or if you specify a value of, say, 60, it means this conversation will expire after 1 minute or 60 seconds. I'll just leave this as 0. Or if you want to, you can just completely omit this entirely. Now, adding history to our application is super simple. It simply goes down to this memory object. And within memory, there's a property called chat memory, which we will set equal to history. And believe it or not, that is actually all we need to integrate long-term conversation memory into our application. So let's test this in the terminal. And everything might seem similar to the previous run, where we can see the memory being populated and we do get our response back. But if we go back to Upstash, we can now click on data browser. And within data browser, we can now see that session, which we called chat1, and we can see our conversation history on this page. So what we can do now is comment out this first message, and let's simply ask, what is my name? And previously, the model wouldn't have any chat history to work with, but if we run this now, we can already see that the conversation history was fetched from Upstash, and therefore the model was able to answer the question. And if we continue this conversation, you'll simply see more messages being added to this table. So if I refresh this page, we can see that 2 additional messages were added to this table. Just another note on agents. If you follow the series, specifically the agent video, you might recall that we also injected history into our agent. And for this solution, we also simply appended the messages to a chat history list. We can implement the same memory solution for agents by simply adding another property to the agent executor called memory. And you can then implement memory in the exact same way we did in this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more LangChain content.